Okay, on this video, I'm going to show you how to make a quick organization chart onto one of your slides. If you notice my current slide, I haven't added anything into that. I just added a new slide. And if you look at some of these items, we can add a table, we can add a chart. The one that we're going to use is called a SmartArt. And then we can also add pictures and clip arts and sound and videos. But I want to pick on this one that's called a SmartArt. Now, if you notice, there's many different types of diagrams that you can use. So you want to go through some of these, and perhaps some of these are things that you can use at work. But of course, an organization chart is called a hierarchy chart. So I want to pick on hierarchy, and then let's use this format over here. Or maybe this one. Now you're going to notice that the slide now has the organization chart, and each different box here is going to be a different person. So let's just say that I want to put my own name up here, and now you see that person is now in that box. Another thing I like to do is click right inside the box and maybe add a second line for the title. So now let's just say that I have two vice presidents. So I'm going to click on this next box, and I can either type in the text here, or I can just click on the actual box and type it there. So let's say I have Mary, she's a vice president, and Hillary, so she's a vice president. So you can see each different box is going to be a different person. Now maybe under Mary I have a few people. Maybe I have Vince. Vince is a manager. I have Carol. Carol's a manager. And maybe I have Jean. And Jean is a manager. All right, so you can see each person will be a different box. However, your organization chart will probably have more than a few people like this. So watch what you're going to do. Let's say I want people to be under Vince. You're going to come over here and you're going to pick on add shape. Now if you add shape before or after, that'll be on the same level as the person that you just picked. For example, if I say add somebody before Vince, notice how it puts it on the same level. So in this case, let's say Sean is on that same level, and I'm going to make Sean a manager. So I'm going to pick on Vince again. I'm going to pick on add shape. So if you add somebody before or after, that'll be on the same level as the person that you're on at this time. But if I wanted employees below Vince, then I'm going to say add shape below. And notice what it does. It redraws a shape and it redraws the lines for you appropriately. So let's say under Vince, let's say we have Bill. And let's say Bill is an office worker. All right, but you can see that all I'm doing is I'm going to click on the boxes, and then you pick on add shapes, and you can start to make a very nice organization chart. Now, let me show you some more things you can do with this. Notice how we have these different layouts. So if you're not happy with the layout that you have, you can pick on one of these, and you can see how it's going to change for you. All right, so that's an interesting thing to experiment with. I kind of do like this one, though. Now, you can change the color scheme. All right, if I pick one of these, notice how the color scheme changes right away very easily. Then we can also change the style. So notice how maybe I'll make it 3D. And, you know, that's looking pretty good. And then we have all these different styles that you can try as well. Now, once you're done with that, you just click somewhere else, and now the organization chart is part of that slide, as we can see. I'm going to add a title here. I'm just going to click there and say organization chart. All right. Now I'm just going to click there, and now we have our organization chart. If I go to a different slide, you can see that that's still down there. Now to make the organization chart, what we did was a new slide, and then if you notice this one over here, it's called Insert SmartArt. You're going to click on that, and then you have lots of different SmartArt styles, and all of them will work pretty much the same way as the organization chart. But to make an organization chart, you're going to use one that's called hierarchy, as you can see, and then you start picking your format, and then away you go. Actually, what I'm going to do is cancel that out and delete that slide. To delete that slide, I'm going to right-click on the slide, and then I'm just going to say delete, as we can see. But now we have a perfect way to make an organization chart in Microsoft PowerPoint.